Hey, I'm Cece, and this is The Price of Flesh. Obviously, this game is going to be a little bit intense. It's got a ton of trigger warnings, so viewer discretion is absolutely advised. What's your name? Cece. The game may use pronouns for the player in some dialogue. Your choice will not affect any body descriptions or gameplay, only the use of pronouns in some dialogue. Very cool. This game contains optional sexual content, including nudity, non-consensual sex acts, detailed descriptions of sex acts, and sexually explicit art. Turning sexual content off will remove all of these scenes and art from gameplay. Sexual content is not included in completion rewards or percentages. Let's go ahead and keep it off then. Hey. She's waking up. Oh, just a sec. Something was pressed against my face. I barely had time to register the sound of a car's engine before I passed out again. Where? Whoa. Where am I? I looked down, horrified to see only shackles. I couldn't see anyone else. Hello? It's a party. Suddenly, a cheerful voice rang through speakers placed around the room. Good evening, and welcome. Ladies and gentlemen, have I got a treat for you. She's fresh, healthy, and alert. I'm sure she'll be versatile enough to fulfill any of your needs. The voice chuckled softly. Now I'm sure you all know the drill. I'll start asking questions, and you lovely folks can begin bidding at any time. Get on with it. Shut up unless you're bidding. You sound like a hag. You little shit. I bet you can't even afford anything here. Get back to... Now. Shouldn't we save our passion for the main event? For a moment, the voices went silent. Shall we ask our items some questions and begin the bidding? Item. Awesome. Yes, please. Excellent. Let's begin. We'll start the bidding at 100. 100? Wonder briefly about what it was even 100 of. Better be, like, 100 million. I decided I didn't want to know what I was worth. Here's our first question. What are you doing here? I waited for a moment, realizing he was addressing me. I don't know. How the hell should I know? Or refused to answer. How the hell should I know? 110. Oh, no. Wonderful. Now, do you consider yourself to be athletic? Abso-fucking-lutely not. No. There was no point in lying. Not really. 130. Here's a fun one. Are you scared? Yes! I'm in shackles in a crazy room being auctioned. The hell kind of questions are these? I doubted that I could hide the shaking in my legs anyways. Fine. Yeah. 150. Okay, let's see. How much money do you make? Nothing. I am a poor person. Good. Okay. How well do you follow instructions? Nobody bit on me after I said I was poor. I'm not answering any of your instructions. I don't know. I can follow instructions just fine. I don't know. Depends on the instruction. Don't worry, just a couple left. Do you enjoy camping? Fuck no. I stood there stunned for a moment. What does that have to do with any of this? I hate camping. I looked down. I'd rather be camping than here, though. 160. All right. You're doing wonderfully. Last question. Who would you like to go home with? I looked at the windows across from me in the dark room. None of them. I don't want to be sold, you asshole! Yeah. I lost my cool and shouted into the room. Fuck you people! Oh my. 170? Hell yeah, my price is going up. I hope this isn't $170. 180? Ooh! 200? 220? 270? 280? All right, you damn bitch. 380. Choke on it. Enjoy. We do love some competition. Now, I hear 380. Anyone else? Oh, I got sold. To the obstreperous gentleman in red. We'll prepare the shipment to send out with you right away. Thank you very much for coming. Shipment? What did that mean? I felt a sharp jab in my ankle. I tried to bend down to inspect the pain, but I just crumpled to the floor. There was pain in my leg and I couldn't move. I was seeing double and trying to speak. But I passed out. The sound of a motor began to cut through the darkness. Before I opened my eyes, I felt someone grab my arms. How are you still asleep? Who are you? My eyes snapped open as the hands dragging me dropped my head unceremoniously into the hot sand. Wakey, wakey. I coughed in the dry heat. Where? My question died in my throat as I looked around and realized that there were more people here. Wow, even cuter than the last one. Yeah. Hey, Derek, how much did you pay this time? Shut the fuck up. He's not even denying it. What the hell is going on? It was apparent that the angry blonde guy was the one that brought me here. My arms were tied behind my back and my legs were tied together. I struggled to push myself to sit upright so I could see better. There were other people tied up like me, two men and a crying woman. Watch the men in masks try to communicate with the other captives. I don't think anybody's gonna talk to me right now, so maybe we just see what they're doing. I turned my attention back to our captors. I told you to call me Scorpion. Okay, Scorpion. Maybe you shouldn't have told us your name then, idiot. You don't have any idea who you're talking to. I could make you disappear. No one would ever find the body. Try it. He's so mad his fist is shaking. Whoever these people are, they don't seem to be friends. I froze as I saw another mask. Maybe I could turn them against each other. The three arguing men were so loud that I didn't notice a fourth man in the back. Hello? He seemed to be staring right at me. Does he have a knife? Come on, let's just start. Jesus Christ, Derek. I think you mean Scorpion. You have the patience of a toddler. Shut up! I've waited a whole fucking year for this. The sound of an approaching motor caught everyone's attention. Finally, I struggled against my binding. The terror building in my chest was telling me that I really didn't want to find out what these people were waiting for. The sound of the engine stopped with the muttering of the three men. The rope wasn't budging. There he is. Another man in a mask emerged, roughly dragging a bound woman. She was fully awake and wildly thrashing. I recoiled back automatically as he came close and dumped her face first in the sand next to me. Damn, Jack. Another wild one. Let me... I flinch as I watch him kick her down to silence her. It's better that way. The older-looking masked man stood up straight, cracking his back and neck. So, are we ready to get started then? Hell yeah. We should do first blood again. It really sets the mood for the rest of them. That doesn't sound good. Sets the mood. It's important. Sure, might as well kick it off. Yeah, okay. Which one though? Not me. I want to chase mine. We can do one of ours. Hey, wait. We really only need one. Yeah. So disappointed. All right, fine. Oh, the girl then. The crybaby. No, please. You two okay with dropping one of yours? Yeah, sure. The one named Jack approached the sobbing woman and grabbed her. He dragged her into the middle of the group. Look away, keep watching, try to distract them. What am I gonna do to distract them? I'm bound. Look how much she's crying already. I haven't even done anything yet. The panic on her face rose to a new level as Derek pulled out a large knife. "Please don't." He grabbed a fistful of her hair and pushed the knife up to her throat. "Keep begging." She sobbed loudly. "Please." Suddenly, she shrieked. While I was watching Derek, Jack had stabbed a switchblade into her thigh. My heart leapt into my throat. This is real. This isn't a joke. They're going to kill her. I began to feel sick as I watched Derek cut the skin around her neck while laughing in her face. Yikes. Jack withdrew his knife and began stabbing her legs repeatedly. Blood was pouring from her wounds. I can't watch this anymore. I couldn't move or scream or do anything to help her. I could only shrink back as I heard more shuffling, laughing, and screaming. Her crying and terrified screams only seemed to excite them all more. I cringed away from the growing frenzy. She had stopped begging a while ago. She was only screaming wordlessly now. It rang through my head as I kept my head down and my eyes closed. I was shaking as I realized tears were rolling down my face, too. She was choking and sobbing now. I couldn't take it anymore. I looked away to the faces of the other captives. "Hey, guys." The skinny man was staring at the ground. The other man had his eyes shut tight, tears streaming down his face. The woman that Jack brought was watching every move with so much rage that it sent a chill through me. We need to partner with her. We need to make sure that, we are besties, because she's going to get us through this. We were all probably thinking the same thing. We're next. A glint of metal caught my attention past the chaos. It was the last man, with the plain mask. He finally moved from his position. The others were too engrossed in their torture to notice his approach. "Oh, hey." I sucked in a breath as I saw him raise a large machete. My body jerked as I watched him bring down the weapon with so much force that she was instantly beheaded. Jesus. I don't know if it was shock or if everything really did go quiet for a moment. It felt like slow motion, like in a nightmare. "What the fuck? You could have cut my hands off." The two men in lizard masks laughed to each other. "Always right to the point, eh, machete?" "Makes sense." Jack straightened himself up. "I'm here to kill." The other man stared for a second before barking out a sharp laugh. "Aren't we all?" They all seemed to calm down when they cleaned off their blades and backed away from the corpse. "All right, let's get this party started for real." I tried not to look at the woman's body and the spreading dark red in the sand beneath her severed head. The man with the plain mask approached us. I scrambled, trying to get away to no avail. He knelt down in front of the crying man and cut the ropes on his arms. The captive wasted no time in getting up and running out into the desert. He did the same with the skinny man, then the woman. The woman seemed to hesitate slightly before she ultimately ran as well. "Wait for me, madam." Then he turned to me. I knew he was just going to cut my rope too, but I couldn't stop the terror flooding in my body as he got close. At this distance, I could see into the eye holes of his mask. I had never seen such raw hatred. He wasn't laughing. As soon as I felt the rope fall away, my body reacted on its own. I leapt to my feet and ran with every bit of strength I could muster. I don't know how long I ran for, but eventually the heat and exhaustion won the battle against my terror, and I collapsed to the ground. I heaved and groaned on the coarse sand. It's so hot. Oh, that doesn't look good. Oh, okay. We're looking pretty okay so far. If these psychos don't kill me, this desert probably will. I have to try and think straight and figure out what I'm going to do next. I blinked in the bright sunlight and tried to get my bearings. Aside from sandy nothing, there seemed to be a rocky hill up ahead to my right and a sort of fissure down to my left. And the camp with those men behind me. Oh, okay. It's really quiet for now. So I can stay here, walk towards the camp, walk down to the fissure, or walk up to the hill. I'm worried that we're gonna get, trapped on this fissure, so, or inside of it, so I think we're gonna go to the hill. I climbed up to the highest part of the hill. A breeze flowed past. I can pretty much see all around. No signs of civilization at all. Well, nothing but that little camp I woke up in. Wonder if there's like a car or something. Go into the open desert. I don't know. Yeah, I guess, but it's open. Yeah, well, we're also at the top of a hill. Let's go. I stumbled slightly. The heat felt like it was coming in waves. The wavering horizon was beginning to make me feel sick. I heard something. The distant high-pitched motor of some kind of vehicle. That can't be good. Where are we gonna hide, though? I mean, we can't outrun the vehicle. There's no time to run. I got down low to the ground and tried to be as still and quiet as possible. As the motor drew closer, I began to hear more sounds. Terrified yelps and mocking laughter. I peeked out towards the cacophony. It was the skinny guy, and one of the psychos on a quad bike chasing him. We need that quad bike. We gotta steal that. I gasped as the running man turned directly toward me. Oh, fuck. Did he see me? Shit. There's no time to think. The thudding and yelling closed in on my position instantly, and for a long second, the running man looked into my eyes. Hey, there's someone hiding here. Oh, go fuck yourself. What the fuck? I got up to my knees in time to see his pursuer heading straight for me. I got up and sprinted. The running man split off from me. I looked behind to see which target the bike was chasing. It's me. Fuck. I turned ahead too late to stop myself from tripping over a dry bush. I barely had time to register the pain of the fall before four wheels skidded to a stop right next to me. Oh, hey, Derek. He got off the bike, lazily swinging a metal bat. He sold you out. How does that make you feel? I tried to scramble away from him. Hey! I cried out sharply as he slammed the bat down on my leg. I asked you a question. Made me pissed. Mad, goddammit. He barked another laugh. Yeah, I bet you are. He stepped closer to me. I knew we'd meet again, you know. In fact, I'm glad I found you instead. You? I tried to move back as I saw him raise the bat again. Pain and sound exploded from the side of my head as I was knocked into the dirt. Everything's ringing. I tasted blood. Belonged to me. I looked back up to see he was crouched over me, his bat replaced with a large knife. I could kill you right now if I wanted to. But I've been waiting a really long time to have this kind of fun. He gripped my chin and forced me to look right at him. I've got a little deal for you, so listen up. It's a special deal, just for you, since you're mine. You do as I say, exactly as I say, and I'll let you go. You can run around in the sand again. But if you fuck it up, I'll finish you off and go find that other guy again. Why is he not wearing a mask? He's the only one not in a mask. So, what's it gonna be? I mean, yeah, what do you need? I wanna live, yeah, mm-hmm. I can swallow my pride, absolutely. He stood up and flashed the knife. Get up on your knees. I gulped and reluctantly obeyed. Now, stick out your tongue, oh God. I eyed the knife nervously. My heart was pounding. If I say no, whatever he'll do would definitely be worse. I opened my mouth and stuck out my tongue. He leaned in and placed the knife's blade in my mouth. Good girl. I scrunched my eyes shut and braced for the pain, but it didn't prepare me. He dragged the blade slowly through my tongue. Pain blossomed and burned from my mouth as it filled with blood. When the blade was gone, I doubled over and groaned from the agony, letting the blood spill from my lips. Let me see. I was trembling now. I raised my head and opened my mouth again. His satisfied smile was making me feel sick. Punch him! Punch him right in the dick! You look good like that. Not just the blood, but that super pathetic look on your face. Punch him in the dick! I quickly looked down. We're not done yet. I gritted my teeth. I can't take much more of this. He leaned back against the quad and tapped his foot on the ground. Lick my boot. Tight. I looked up at him in disbelief. That'll make my tongue infect Ed. His expression made it pretty clear he was serious. I looked down as he tapped his foot again. Fuck. I already let him cut my tongue. Can't stop now. I lowered myself down to his foot. I opened my mouth. It hurts so bad. I don't want to. I forced myself down and dragged my burning tongue over the dirty boot. I breathed raggedly. The pain was making me gasp. I made sure I did it slowly and properly. I did not want to have to do it again. I finally raised my head up, shaking from the now bloody boot. He was grinning wildly. Nice. Look at your face. You did good. I flinched as he reached to pull something off the quad, then threw it on the ground beside me. Good enough for a reward. A canteen? Ooh, water! We can have some water to wash the dirt down with. He got back into the seat of the bike. The motor roared back to life. Let's see who finds you next. The bike dug in and threw rocks up at me as he took off laughing. I grabbed the canteen, somewhat surprised to still be alive. Okay. I mean, we're still doing pretty okay. Our sanity's looking a little not great, but... So we already went up to the hill. Maybe, I guess we go down to the fissure? I crawled down into the rocky fissure. I sighed with relief as I slid into a small shaded alcove to get out of the sun. Maybe we stay here for a sec. I stayed in the fissure area. Oh, okay. I guess go back out to the desert. I wiped the sweat from my brow. It's so hot and dry. I gulped and tried to ignore the sting of the sun. Do we try the camp? I don't know. It's getting dark, so I can't imagine they're still going to be out there during nighttime. Maybe I go down to the fissure and try to find somewhere to sleep. Just stay here for the night, girl. Go to sleep. You're not gonna do that. Okay. So we're at the hill. Can see a bit better. Oh, we're gonna starve. Can I have some of my water? Will that help? I opened the canteen and took a precautionary sniff. It smells okay, but I can't really afford to be picky out here. I started with a sip and soon found myself gulping. I was so thirsty. It was empty too soon. Well, I feel a lot better anyway. Hey, okay, cool. So we feel pretty full. I guess go towards the camp. I've made it into the camp. Somehow, I don't think anyone is here. I better not stay here for long. Can we forage? Can we... Okay. So what do we do now? I've made it into the open desert. The sun is high and it's boiling hot. Can I go to... Oh, dang it! Ah, all right. Okay, let's sleep for a little bit. I was jolted awake by the sound of a scream. I instinctively dropped lower out of sight. The commotion drew closer. Get the fuck away from me! I heard the scrape and hurried shuffle of rocks nearby. My mind raced as I heard the thump of someone falling to the ground. Two voices were grunting in effort. The urge to look was overwhelming. No, stay down. I stayed down low in the fissure. Whatever's going on out there, I'm better off staying out of it. I think you've been running long enough. I think I recognized that voice. It was one of the masked men. Eat shit. The other voice. She sounded exhausted. I kept still as I heard more shuffling and struggling. He grunted angrily, then suddenly the dull thud of someone being hit. Hard. I listened for the woman, but I could only hear him panting. Is she? I resisted the curiosity and kept my head down. Come on, wake up. That's right. I had a really bad feeling this was going to get a lot worse. Time for you to squeal for me. Uh-oh. I squeezed my eyes shut, but only silence followed. What's that? So much to say before, and now you're suddenly shy? I jolted as a shriek suddenly tore through the air. I shrank down, trying to be as small and invisible as possible. She kept screaming. I shivered as her cries got weaker. I can't do anything. Soon, there was silence again. I heard a small amount of shuffling as he got up. It's definitely over. I stayed until I was certain that he must be gone. I have to get out of here. I searched around myself. Nothing but a dead lizard. Okay. Our energy's back up a little bit, but we are about to starve. I made it into the open desert. Let's go up to the hill. Can't do anything here. Okay. Let's go to the camp. I slowly approached the small structure in the heat. There's shade. I took a step forward. Then something moved. Oh? Fuck. I flinched as I heard the voice. No, I didn't see anyone. He stepped into view. You're not the one I brought. As he began to take steps toward me, I instinctively took matching steps backward. You don't look like you can run very far at all. His steps started getting faster. I need to leave. Now. I turned on my heel as he leaned into a sprint. I ran away from the camp. I could hear his heavy footfalls behind me. Fuck. What was I thinking? I was already so exhausted. I gulped and ran harder. My body was pulling from some kind of energy I didn't know about. He's not giving up. I kept running, squeezing my eyes shut and sweating. He's right behind me. A stumble. I kept going. I'm slowing down, aren't I? A hand grasped at my flimsy shirt, brushing it. Panic and running faster. I have to. Everything hurt. The heat made the air feel thick. How is he still only just behind me? A hand swiping at my back again. My brain is screaming to run, but my body is beginning to disobey. My legs falter. Another swipe, the same distance. He's playing with me. This is a game. The realization comes as my legs crumple under me. I was driven painfully into the sand by his body weight. Oh no. I can't. I'm so dizzy from the heat and running that I barely notice as he turns my limp body over to face him. Caught you. I gasp for air, completely unable to get my body to move. His hands wrapped around my neck. Oh man. His grip tightened and I tried to fight, but I could barely lift my arms. He leaned in close. You're making this really easy for me. I choked on my last wheeze. I couldn't breathe. I grabbed uselessly at his arms. They may as well have been made from rock. I could only lie there as my lungs pulled again and again at the inside of my chest. His hands kept tightening. No amount of panic could move my body now. I laid there under him as, mercifully, dizziness dulled out the rest of any other sensation. The sun. Okay. Well, let's try that one again. Okay. We're back here. I did all of the same choices. Let's try to survive this time. Okay, so let's go up the hill so we can get the map. Which has nothing on it, because there's nothing here. So, the last time we went out into the open desert, we had that guy coming, yeah. So maybe we should try to run this time. I ran as fast as I could towards the fissure. I crawled down into the rocky fissure. I sighed with relief as I slid into a small, shaded alcove to get out of the sun. Stay here. Stay in the fissure area, see if you can find anything. I searched around myself. Nothing but a dead lizard. Yeah, the only thing that sucks is now we don't have the water. Which is not good. Okay. So it's nighttime. We might be able to go to the camp. Nobody there. Okay, so let's see if we can find anything here. There's some chairs, a burnt out fire. I looked for weapons, but I couldn't find anything. No food. I saw a glint of metal. I rushed over behind a chair and saw a couple of canteens. My breath hitched. Water? I quickly lifted them and checked. Light? I unscrewed the caps. Damn it! Empty. I dropped them. There's nothing here I can use. Awesome. Okay. Well, we should probably sleep. So let's go down here and go to sleep. I gasped as I woke up. I looked around myself and remembered where I was. I groggily got back up. Okay, so our energy is all the way back, which is good, but we are about to starve. Okay. I kept walking through the recess between the rocks. Oh, is that? A shallow pool of water. Hey, barely larger than a puddle. Water. Let's drink it. It tastes bitter. I tried to spit the rest out, but I already swallowed a bunch. Oh, are we gonna die now? Maybe if I just... I took a step forward and stumbled. What? My heart started pounding as I tried to take another step. I fell to the ground. Something's wrong with my arms and legs. I can't move. Fuck. I realized that I was hyperventilating. I can't panic now. That's not going to help. Whatever it is, has to wear off. I just have to hope that no one finds me. Well, okay. Well, they're gonna because they planted that. Fuck. It isn't getting better. My arms and legs are paralyzed. And it feels like there's something watching me. It's been hours. I need to move. I need to get somewhere safe. I heard footsteps over the sand. Once more, I tried in vain to get up. I could only lay there helplessly as the footsteps got closer. Hey, machete. Terror flooded my motionless body as the white mask came into view above me. You can't run. I couldn't answer. But that wasn't really a question anyway. For a moment, the weapon in his hand seemed too heavy in his grip. Then he raised it like it was nothing. The illusion was gone. There was no time left for fear. Ugh. Okay, well, next time we won't drink the water. Let's try again. Okay, we're back to where the water is. Let's not drink it this time. I looked at the water. Maybe I shouldn't just be drinking any stagnant water I find around. I'll just survive without it for now. I can always come back. Okay, well, our food is at zero. We really should be sleeping during the day and walking around at night. Uh-oh. Let's run again. I'm not staying here to find out what or who that is. I ran as fast as I could down towards the fissure. I crawled down into the rocky fissure. I sighed with relief as I slid into a small shaded alcove to get out of the sun. Okay. Nope, we're still not going to drink that water. Okay. I stopped for a moment and rubbed the back of my neck. I'm thirsty. I'm getting a headache, too. I wish I could find some water. There doesn't seem to be a way out of the sun, though. From the top of this hill. Let me look around. I searched over the sharp rocks. There's nothing useful here at all. I stumbled slightly. The heat felt like it was coming in waves. The wavering horizon was beginning to make me feel sick. My vision wavered. I tried to move, but I couldn't. I collapsed to the ground. I didn't have the energy to move on. I struggled for a moment longer, then passed out. No bueno. What happened? Everything hurts. I can't move. How long has it been? I was barely able to turn my head to see my severely sunburnt skin. I must have passed out. Everything is spinning. I don't even have the energy to lift my hand. Oh, hey, machete. It's one of them. I knew I should be scared, but everything still felt so fuzzy. Are you real? Who? What? What are you? It's better this way. The blade came down with no hesitation. Okay. Yeah. Let's try again. Okay, so at this point, I'm just like, with the heat being what it is, you can't really move around during the day, like to the camp and stuff. Anyways, I'm wondering if we should just sleep during the daytime. And do all of our exploring at nighttime. Okay, so we are going to go to sleep. Oh. But we're not tired enough to sleep. So I guess we'll just be awake during the daytime because that makes a ton of sense. Okay, so let's go to the camp. See if we can find anything up on the hill. A strange glow caught my eye. I carefully walked over to where the ground seemed to be flickering with a soft light. Upon closer inspection, the hillside was covered by a camouflaged cloth. I tentatively lifted the cloth. It's a door? Let's go in there. I have to see what's in there. Yeah, there's nothing for me out here anyways. True facts. I gulped and cautiously opened the door just enough to slide in. I tried to make as little noise as possible. What the hell? As my eyes adjusted, the first thing I saw was candles. Who? Dragon! A sharp blow to the back of the head sent me sprawling forward on the raised dirt table in the middle of the cave. Nice. I scrambled to push myself up, but a large hand shoved me back down. Where's the rope? God dang it. Got it. I tried harder to squirm out, but the grasp holding me down got much heavier. I wheezed as the air was pushed from me. Put their arms out. My arms were wrenched out in front of me as I was pushed face first into the table. I couldn't do anything to stop him from quickly tying my wrists together with a thin, scratchy rope. Komodo. Oh my god, their names are Komodo Dragon. Maybe we should just use them and do it now? He seemed to be taking his time deciding. What is it they want to do? Sacrifice me, obviously. No, we need more time to get ready. Hey, don't worry. That doesn't mean we're gonna let them go. I was suddenly flipped over onto my back on the dirt table between them. Extra blood will make it better. What if we can't find our boy after? Relax. Jack is busy with the girl he brought. I don't know what the fuck Machete wants, but he brought his own guy too. And Derek's an idiot. There's nothing to worry about. We'll do it properly. Okay. Give me the knife. I gasped in fear as I saw an overly ornate knife passing hands between them. My body filled with adrenaline. I lurched upward, trying to thrash my way free. The one named Dragon grabbed my shoulders and slammed me back down onto the table. No, stop. Komodo raised the knife above my abdomen. Please, don't do this. My yelling and squirming were completely ignored. I let out a blood-curdling scream as he plunged the knife into my belly, just below my ribcage. Agony clouded my vision. I gagged and whimpered as I felt the blade push further up into me under my ribs. Did you have to do it so quickly? I couldn't fight anymore. The knife seemed to hurt more coming out than when it went in. Blood poured from me as I stared at the wet blade. I convulsed as I tried to keep breathing. You always do that. You know we don't have time to play around. I couldn't keep my eyes open. This is just the appetizer. I'm doing great. Okay, so let's leave the door alone. My curiosity was strong, but my survival instinct was stronger. Whatever was in there must have been set up by the masked men. I'm not messing with that. I walked away from the door to a safe distance on the hillside. Okay, so let's go here. Look around. Oh, nope. Don't drink that water. Don't drink that water. Okay. How much time do we have left until... I woke up abruptly and rubbed the back of my neck. I'm thirsty. I'm getting a headache, too. I wish I could find some water. The dry air was cut with a sharp scream. Ah, yes. I wonder what happens if we peek. Because we know staying down will save us. I turned around and carefully raised my head up. One of the masked men, and one of the captives. It was clear the man had the upper hand, despite the captive's desperate struggling. I think you've been running long enough. Yeah, we saw this. I stared in horror as she threw a handful of sand directly at the mask's eye holes. The retaliation was immediate. He punched her in the face so savagely that she went limp. He sat up over her and took a canteen from his hip. He took several gulps and looked back down at her. Then I saw the flash of a blade. If I don't do something, he's gonna kill her. Well, I mean, we've died like 50 kabillion times at this point. Let's try. Stop! He froze. The mask slowly turned to me as regret flushed through my body. The woman under him bucked suddenly, throwing him off. There was no time to think. Over here! She ran toward me and I extended my hand. He leapt to his feet. I pulled her down into the fissure and in front of me. Run! She found her footing. I watched her gain distance for a split second before I was tackled to the ground. She paused and looked back, clearly pained at my position. Go! I did feel some relief as I watched her take off in a sprint. However, it quickly died out as the man on top of me turned me over to face him. You know, I really don't mind the trade. See where your altruism's gotten you? I have to fight. There's no other options left. I wrenched out of his grip and lashed out, hitting him in the jaw and sending his mask flying. Yes! So, I mean, our health and energy are, like, all the way up. Let's fight this bitch. What's up, Jack, you ugly ass? Is that how you want to play it? He raised his fist, and my blood ran cold as I finally got a good look at his weapon. Brass knuckles with a blade. What a coward. Like, can't do all of this without these? Like, that's a little excessive. I rolled out of the way a split second before his fist collided with the ground above my head. Yes! Come here! I tried to scramble to my feet, but he yanked me back by the collar of the flimsy top. I instinctively blocked my face, taking a slash with the blade of his weapon to my forearms instead. I fell backwards. I screamed as the same blade pinned my shoulder to the ground. I grasped at his arm, trying to get free as he kept grinding it into my body. Quit squirming. I screamed again as he twisted the knife in my shoulder. Before I could recover, he tore the knife out and hit me in the side of the head with the metal knuckles. Dang it! Pain exploded in my head. My ears were ringing. I barely noticed him grab my face at first. Now you're gonna squeal for me. The blade kept getting closer to my face. Oh, come on. I'm really hoping that that girl comes back and like, knocks him in the head or something. I tried to squirm out, but he held my head with an iron grip. Closing my eyes did nothing. He pressed the blade slowly into my eyelid. Oh, no. I screamed with everything in my body as it penetrated further into my eye. I kept screaming as he pulled it out. The pain was too much. I heaved and sobbed. He kept me pinned with one hand as the point of his blade pushed into my gut. I couldn't stop screaming. He never moved quickly. I wailed as he bled as the knife kept pushing in, and again, until finally, after what felt like an eternity, I couldn't scream anymore. Okay, well, definitely I gotta save that bitch.